She started playing chess at 5, a prodigy who went on to become world champion. Over the board, she's aggressive, she's fearless. She inspires. Here in Gibraltar, the world's strongest women players are fighting with the world's best for a record prize fund. Women chess is fundamental to the Tradewise Gibraltar Chess Festival. She is one of our stars. You know her as the chess queen, Grandmaster Alexandra Kosteniuk.
Hi Alexandra, welcome to the Tradewise Gibraltar Chess Festival. Welcome back. How does it feel to be here?
It's fine. Well, the tournament is just starting, so all the games are ahead of me.
Absolutely.
I'll see how it goes. You never know.
How did you begin playing chess? How did it start for you?
For kids, most of the things start with their parents. And in my family, chess started with my father. It was his idea. And he started to teach us, my sister and I. I have a younger sister. And that definitely helped to have a sibling next to me, because we had some kind of competition. It didn't last long fortunately or unfortunately for my sister, but somehow my father didn't have enough time to spend with both of us. When I started traveling, he went to travel with me, and more tournaments came, and so somehow my sister decided to take another route, which is also a very nice idea.
What was that like growing up in a country where chess has such a strong history and culture, to experience that? What was that like, the whole scenario?
My whole chess journey was not that, bright all the years that I went through. Because I had wonderful years when I was winning most of the tournaments in my age category. And then I had a disastrous years when I was losing all the time. So, and I was also growing in such a moment where we had problems with political problems. The Soviet Union collapsed, and Russia was struggling in the first years. What's good that, because of this Soviet chess school, I've always had very strong competition, despite the situation in the country. This competition, you have to have strong players next to you that you compete with, and you try, you grow together. Definitely having a great chess culture and many chess stars, men and women, help, because you have to have role models, especially for young kids. They have to see what they're aiming for. They have to be motivated somehow. So definitely when you talk, when you win a lot, and when you show these chess players that win, a boy or a girl might have a dream to become like one of them. And that's what they're working for. So I think just having a great chess culture and many strong players help.
You spoke about this Soviet school. Now in today's time, we actually use that often to describe the style of play of a particular player. You know, the Soviet chess learning or the Soviet school of chess. What exactly is that?
Well, it's an attitude, we can say, toward chess. It's the whole culture. We focus a lot of learning the games of our predecessors, chess history, and there have been millions of games that have been played before us. And also we focus a lot on chess preparation. That's, I also think, is a difference between this. Well, not difference, but that's what the Soviet school is famous for. To underline this strengths of a player,
yes,
or strengths of his knowledge. Because for me, chess, Soviet chess school is more like knowledge of chess, understanding of chess, and something that, you know, cannot be compared to a modern computer world, and that's kind of thing. So we never really know whether it existed or not.
And growing up in Russia, was the training with boys and girls working together on chess, or was it separate? How was that?
Well, we didn't have that many girls like nowadays, and Well, I was the only, I think, in my chess club, never created a problem, and actually I was feeling quite comfortable in my chess club, so, and playing mostly with the boys. So, well, even nowadays there are more boys and girls that play, and parents somehow, when they have a daughter, they don't really consider chess to be their number one priority. But it's been changing.
And did you always know that this is what you wanted, that you were going to be a chess player from a young age?
Never. I even now wonder, what am I doing? I mean, I've never had this feeling comparing myself to other players, talking, well, throughout my career, I've had an honor to talk and to discuss many things with great chess players. I've never really considered myself as to have a really chess talent. I still wonder what are my strong sides, and I know my weak sides better than my strong sides. And somehow it surprises me even nowadays that I've had such a great chess career and I still continue to play chess. So yeah, I had these questions I asked myself many, many times since, as I already mentioned, I had very rough years. And when I'm at the point to quit, or I'm at the point of doing something else, somehow, yeah, chess keeps with me. Somehow, something happened in my life that
keeps you going.
Yeah.
So. Do you feel that perhaps chess needs to be integrated? Men and women need to play together to have more women in the top 100 in the world? Or should chess have separate tournaments and separate prize funds for women?
Well, that's a very tricky question. I don't know. I've seen some advocates that say that we need to abolish women's titles, and that women are actually capable of playing, competing with men, and we are, as we show sometimes with our results. But the problem is that it confuses people. You either forget about women's titles and play all together, which will ruin women's chess.
At least for the time being.
For the time being, yeah. I don't know, for 50, for 100 years, it will ruin women's chess because, we're definitely not ready for this step.
Yes.
Or we separate women and men. And we keep, in any other sports tournament separated. We don't compete together, only for fun or for entertainment. And I think that will be better for women's chess and for girls that grow, because it will create more women's tournaments, more money, and not so much confusion. Well, I think to support women's chess, you should not
abolish it.
Yeah, abolish it. But somehow you should support it by giving more opportunities for girls to play, showing them that they have a career ahead of them, increasing women's prizes in tournaments, and that will help much more than just forgetting about women's titles.
Right. Now, Alexandra, there was a lot of talk surrounding the Women World Cup happening in Iran or the World Rapid and Blitz happening in Saudi Arabia and Riyadh. What was your stand and your viewpoint on the entire situation?
Well, first of all, I must say that a world championship, it's something that motivates me a lot. And it's like the number one tournament in my whole tournament year. And I cannot just skip it for some kind of reasons that are not very strong enough. For example, in Iran, I was very, very concerned to go, not because of the country or the religion or anything, but because of the political situation. Since my daughter lives in USA, I was very afraid of getting, and I need to get a visa. And so only because of this, I was very, very concerned. But that's the only thing. About Saudi Arabia, well, Iran is also the same story, but somehow I believe that all the players must have a chance to compete. And that's written in the statutes of FIDE, and I think everyone agrees with it. And so it's a very unfortunate situation in the modern world, political situation, when sometimes players are not able to come and compete because of some strange issues in between the countries. And that's the only thing that that worried me. And well, it's still worse, and I cannot really find an answer what to do and how to proceed, because it's not only Saudi Arabia or Iran, or there are many other countries that are in war situations between each other. And even if we talk about Baku, the Olympiad in Baku, Armenian team, I mean, theoretically they were allowed to come, but they never did. So what to do and how to do in the modern world, sometimes it's not so clear. If we talk about women's rights, this issue never really worried me, because first of all, you need to really know the history and the knowledge of what you're talking about in terms of women's rights. I'm not capable of discussing it. Well, it's a different country from Western and European countries. They have different religion and point of views and everything, but we should respect it. And that's the problem also in the modern world, as I see it, that sometimes countries just don't have enough respect for each other. And well, the only problem for me which stands is that not all of the players were allowed to play. But apart from that, it's been, well, in Saudi Arabia, it's been just flawless. It's been a perfect organization, a very good prize fund, which is very good for chess, especially for women's chess, because if we have one tournament with such a prize fund, hopefully more tournaments will come, and that's something that can change women's chess.
Yeah, and also the fact that a country comes forward and puts in so much money in our game, which is a problem that something that chess struggles with, you know, to get sponsors, to find countries to host events. So it's probably something that players need to be open to and to at least try and make it a positive thing.
In general, I think we should talk more about positive things, because there have been such a story about this championship, negative story, and that doesn't help chess.
Yes.
And we should, at least oppose this negative things to positive things,
which also open the way to the future. I mean, if we don't try it, it's never going to change.
Yes. So, and as I've been told, they are trying. Well, at least in Saudi Arabia, they are trying to make it possible for all the players to participate, which we can wish for.
Now, as you have progressed in your career and become a stronger player, is there any one particular quality or trait that you've consciously had to work on in your path to improvement?
Oh, there are many. I think it's a very important thing for a chess player, or actually for any person who are working on something, on some qualities to improve, is to be flexible and to analyze, as I said, strong side and weaknesses. Well, when you're young, you think you're just the best point. When you become older, you become aware of your weaknesses. And you work not only on eliminating them, sometimes it's not possible to eliminate them. Sometimes it's the way you are. But what you learn is to avoid situations when these weaknesses might be critical. And I think that's a very, very important trait for any strong chess player. They're very flexible and they are constantly working on themselves. They're constantly analyzing and self-analyzing.
Very interesting. And also, you're a mother, but you're also a professional chess player. That's something that a lot of women struggle in the chess world, to draw that balance. How's that journey been for you?
Well, yeah, it's almost impossible if you don't have support of your family. But here we have some girls who, well, I'm just the mother of one, and sometimes a big issue, but when you see girls who are mother of two or three kids and they're still capable of playing and playing great and being a professional, then you understand that there is nothing you cannot do. Well, sometimes it's very simple. In chess, in life, as I realized one day, It's either you want to do or you don't want to do. It's either you don't like the situation and you try to change it, or you don't complain with the situation and just go ahead, but just don't complain. In the first years, it's very, very difficult for a mother, I think, mostly to leave a child. So, yeah, but it's, again, it's your choice. If you chose this road, you are just professional.
With all that you have achieved over the years, and where you are, let's say, in your personal life and in your mind space, what is your aim professionally?
Well, for the moment, I'm in chess, and I'm playing and focusing, and there are many tournaments, even this year, that are ahead of me and very interesting for me, and that motivate me a lot, because I have this problem with motivation. Sometimes I become boring, and it's not so interesting for me to play a tournament, and then if I'm lacking motivation, then it's a disaster. But somehow this year seems to be very promising in terms of motivators and in terms of challenging tournaments, so I'm looking really ahead of me. Well, sometimes it seems that you've done a great job to prepare, and then you come and everything just doesn't go your way. So, well, you just need to relax and take it easy. It's easier said than done, but somehow understanding that chess is just a game and there are more important things in life help. And I think that's actually a plus, a big plus when you're a mother. You start to care more about your children, not about chess, which is the way it should be.
Yeah, I've often seen that players start performing even better after becoming a mother.
Yes, because they relax. And okay, you should sometimes take things easy.
Right, and lastly, Alexandra, for 2018, what is it that you're most looking forward to?
Well, there are many, many tournaments, as I told. There is a World Championship. Actually, it seems that the last half of the year will be like a non-stop chess with very, very important tournaments. From September on, it's the Chess Olympiad. You're always excited about it because, I mean, it's a teams event. I've been a big fan of team events since my childhood. I enjoyed playing in team events very much, and I've been playing for Russia, for the main Russian team, since 2002. It's been quite a road already, and we've had many great results, but Chess Olympiad is something special, and it seems every country is preparing for. Then a world championship, a Russian championship somewhere, the Russian super final should be somewhere in between the Olympiad and world championship, and hopefully world rapid and blitz, which I love playing rapid and blitz chess very much, and I hope very much that we will finish the year with those wonderful events.
Sounds very exciting. We wish you all the best for all of it.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.